Brad Pitt. He's coming in a new movie, and the name of it is Fury. And it's about World War II tank commander.
So I'm Josh Revac from the Chapter 593 of the Military Order of the Purple Heart. And here sitting with me is World War II veteran and tanker, Jim McMahon. Jim has a story for us about the time that he met General George Patton.
In 1944, I had an M24 tank, and I had two V8 Cadillac engines in the tank, and I couldn't get them coordinated. I had to go to the motor pool to get the work done. As I pulled into the motor pool, I told my crew of five, I said, let's get the tank cleaned up. So we're in there working, getting the tank scrubbed down, getting it cleaned up, polishing the ammunition and all that good stuff. When I felt a rap on my turret door, because I was the tank commander, and I raised the door, and all I seen was stars, and it was General Patton. I think he had a swagger stick. I'm not sure. Anyway, his exact words were, "Sergeant, get your ass out of that tank. You're going to the Riviera for 5 days." He says, "Where in the hell is the Riviera?" It was quite an experience. And the most important thing I remember of General Patton was in two pearl-handled 45s he had on each ship.
Wow. And now that was in 1944.
Now,
I was a tanker, so I'm fascinated with World War II and how you guys did what you did. Omaha Beach.
Yeah.
You dropped your tank right off of a boat?
Yeah, the LST. They dropped the front. Just drove the tank off. We were supposed to land in 3 feet of water. We landed in 11 feet, and the tank actually floated.
Ouch.
Scared the hell out of all of us.
And you went on to fight in Bastogne, is that right?
Oh, yeah, Bastogne, Battle of the Bulge, Falaise Gap, Nordhausen.
So you were wounded and sent back. Where were you wounded at?
It wasn't a town, but we were in an enclosed compound. It was pretty good size. It was larger than as long as this building here, but it was just as wide. And for the first time in 5 months, we had some hot chow. I had a turkey leg, green beans, mashed potatoes, and gravy. About that time, my platoon commander, Lieutenant Bishop, Mac, come over here, I want to talk to you. He was standing by the door. I walked over to him, and I got about a foot from him, and three mortars exploded over our heads. Killed him instantly. As he died in my arms. He fell behind a stove, and I had to get him out. And I didn't know it at the time that I was wounded also. I found out when I took him to the hospital. He made me get on the Jeep with him. I got on the Jeep with him and took him to the hospital. The doctor said, take him out back. He's gone. And he said, you, get in here. He said, you're wounded. I didn't even realize it. And 28 good friends of mine are buried at St. Mary Gleef. That's the big cemetery. That's when they were killed on D-Day. On my outfit, there was 117 men in the 24th Cavalry. Out of the 117 men, 84 were killed. I lucked out.
Well, I want to thank you for fighting in World War II for us and our country. It means a lot to me, and I know it means a lot to a lot of other folks. You're a huge inspiration to me, Jim. A huge inspiration. Not just, especially as a tanker, because I was a tanker, so that means even so much more to me.
Oh, by the way, Oh, I was interviewed by Holocaust also.
Really? Now, were you at one of the camps when it was liberated?
Nordhausen.
Which one?
Nordhausen.
Nordhausen? Wow, you were part of the liberation.
I was the lead tank going in.
You were the lead tank going into a Nazi death camp to liberate it.
We figured there was 350 or 400 bodies in the pits.
Wow.
You could smell them from 30 miles.
Wow.
And you know the bad part, and a lot of people don't believe this, but I know it's true because I've seen it firsthand. There was three or four children in that pile of bodies, and three of them were still alive.
Really? Wow.
Man, that was awful. But I'll tell you, when I got to the camp, I told my driver, it's Pat, hard right. He says, what the hell for, Mac? I says, break that gate down. I broke the gate down to the prisoners. Wasn't supposed to, but I did.
Wow.
They came running, wanted food. But, you know, you didn't dare give them anything. You'd kill them. And we were told not to give them any food.
Wow.
Anyhow.
Well, thank you so much, Jim.
Hey, you betcha.
You mean the world to us, and I hope you have a good time down in Arizona, and I really appreciate you sharing your story with us and everybody else who sees it. What an amazing story you have.
I'm going to go